Which says the Cratchit family will have as good a Christmas as the Lord Mayor of London himself.
Whoa, shillings.
I do like that dolly in the corner.
Christmas children peek into Christmas windows. See a world as pretty as a dream. Christmas cream, Christmas has a shine, Christmas windows, Christmas boxes tied with pretty bows.
Wonder what's inside, what delights
they hold. But till Christmas morning, no one knows.
Then, my loves, I bought the finest bird in the shop. Well, the finest for 1 and 4 pence.
Christmas children live in a Christmas daydream, waiting for the magic to unfold.
Gorgeous things to wear every Christmas.
So rich are not the Christmas pot of gold.
True, Bess, true.
I do like that dolly in the corner.
I'd rather have the oranges.
Your change, Mrs. Carson, 1840 is the best vintage in 20 years.
I do sure it's older, shouldn't
Happy Christmas to you. Merry Christmas to you, ma'am. This will make the finest party punch, Mrs. Carson, and only 2 pence a penny.
Christmas punch, a Cratchit specialty.
Their Christmas things.
Christmas children hunger for Christmas morning. Christmas days are wanted to be home.
Young ones dreams come true, not so young ones do.
Leave the story we've been told. Christmas is for children young.
Financial burdens of my life are already intolerable. Pray don't add to them by asking me to pay for the upkeep and education of your entire family. Why, yes, as a matter of fact. Except that everyone on the list is going to give me a present. Dolls, toys, carousels. Bah! Christmas humbug.
Which makes some slight provision for the poor and destitute.
Excellent. And I suggest you do so.
You miss our point, sir. The poor suffer greatly at the first time. Many thousands are one becoming necessaries.
Are there any prisons?
Indeed there are, sir. That's one thing there's no shortage of.
And the workhouses? Are they still in operation?
They are, sir, and I wish you could say they're not.
The treadmill and the full bar? Full vigor, I trust.
Both very busy, sir.
I'm very glad to hear it. For a second, I thought that something had occurred to stop them in their useful purpose.
A few of us are endeavoring to raise the fund to buy the poor some meat and drink and means of want. We choose this time because this is a time when want is needly felt and abundance rejoices. What may we put you down for, sir?
Nothing, sir.
So you wish me not?
I wish to be left alone, sir. That is what I wish. I don't make myself merry at Christmas, and I cannot afford to make idle people merry. I've been forced to support the establishments I have mentioned through taxation. Those who are badly off must go there.
Many would rather die than go there.
They would rather die, but I suggest they do it. And decrease the surplus population. Yes, gentlemen, decrease the surplus population. Good night, you boys. Letters, Pharisees and parasites, hypocrites and fools, calculating swindlers, prevaricating frauds, perpetrating goodness as they roam the earth of wars, feeding on their fellow men and reaping rich rewards, contaminating everything they see, corrupting honest men, like me. I hate people. People are despicable creatures, lonesome, inexplicable creatures, good for nothing, pickable creatures. I hate people. I abhor them. When I see the England classes sitting on their England horses, gulping ale from England glasses, I hate people. I detest them. I deplore them. Ladies, you owe me £2.05.
Mr. Scrooge, sir, you've been giving my credit as usual.
So have I. £2.05.
Since it's Christmas, sir, we've been giving people an extra week or two to pay.
Aha! Then I shall give you an extra week to pay.
Thank you, sir.
Which will cost you a further 12 shillings.
12 shillings?
Unless you would prefer me to confiscate your basket and its belongings, which is my legal right.
No, sir. We'll pay, sir.
Is it?
Please, Mr. Scrooge, a few more days.
You've already had a few more days. You can afford to stock turkeys like that. You can afford to pay me.
Yes, Mr. Scrooge. Thank you, Mr. Scrooge.
Fools who have no money spend it, get in debt and try to end it, beg me on their knees, be threatened, knowing I have cash to lend them. Soft-hearted me, kind-working me, clean-living, thrifty, and kind as can be. Situations like this are an interest to me. That's the interest. He's here, Miller. You owe me £2.07.
Not now, Mrs. Scrooge. Please, I'm performing.
Pity it doesn't pay me better. Where's me money?
Tomorrow for sure, Mrs. Scrooge. Today's my best day of the year.
Tomorrow? It will be £2.10. All your puppets belong to me.
All right, Mrs. Scrooge. £2.10.
Man is even meaner than you are. Oh, Merry Christmas to you, sir! What wrong, Mr. Scrooge? I suppose you're talking of Christmas or stale at the compliments of Tom Jenkins.
No.
And there'll be a free kid abroad that will enjoy throughout the coming year, sir. In gratitude of your infinite kindness in giving me another 2 weeks to pay.
1 week.
10 days.
1 week.
1 week.
Put a lid on that stuff. I'll take it home. Pringle! Away.
There he goes. Father Christmas himself. Father Christmas. Father Christmas. He's the meanest man in the whole wide world. The whole wide world. I'll keep a stocking up for your Christmas gift. It's a shame. He's a villain.
What a villain. A villain to play.
On Christmas Day. Happy Christmas. Father Christmas. We just as mean as ever be.
And you can say to all said Father Christmas.
On his Merry Christmas Day.
To say to all said Father Christmas, on his Merry Christmas.
Dog, boys, carousels, bah, Christmas, humbug. I hate Christmas. I hate people. Yuletide loving second-rate people. Nasty little creepy stretches. Dirty walk as 20 misfetches. Empty minds with pettiness stretches further than I can see. What's the reason?
He's a miser!
I hate Christmas.
He's a skipless!
I hate people, women, children, especially nasty smellies.
He's a miser!
It's because they all hate me. Humbug!
Imagine the weight and length of the mighty chain you are making for yourself.
like you have never wandered beyond the narrow limits of our counting house.
You were always a man of business, Jacob.
Mankind is our business, Ebenezer. A household will be attention to. I know this because I've sat invisible at your elbow many and many a day in your office.
My office?
Hear me. My time is almost gone. I am here tonight to warn you. It is your own.
No, Jacob! No!
Not my fault!